In this Q&A video, we're going to answer the question, how do I make sure that my torque screwdriver is setting to the right value? This video relates to the review of the Wiha iTorque driver that I carried out recently, so if you haven't already done so, then please do go and check that video out, as well as the free training module on torque that we created to help you with your CPD. You'll find links to both of these in the description below. So the first question we can ask is, why would we even question if our torque setting device is working properly? After all, that's what we bought it for. Well, all through this video, I'll make comparisons to a multifunction tester that we might use to test out our installation work. So the first thing to bear in mind is that we always check to make sure our tester is working properly in a number of different ways. Simplest of all, we may connect the probes together to make sure that it's giving us a zero value before we check for continuity. We don't just assume that the reading will be correct, even though we've bought it for that exact purpose. So when we use a torque setting device, it will tighten the connection up to whatever value we've got it set to, and then once it reaches that value, it will click and stop transferring your turning action to the driver head due to a mechanically sprung connection inside the driver. Now, that sprung connection inside the driver slips and wears over time, and gradually it will start to change the torque value that the device clicks out at. However, it can be readjusted to the correct setting so that the tool operates correctly. But how do you know when this readjustment needs to be done? Well, there's no strict direction on how often checking and calibration must be done, but there are some industry recognised conventions as well as manufacturers' directions to take into account. Monthly checking can be done by using a device similar to this one made by Wiha. If you remove your driver bit from the torque setting device you want to test and pop in the adapter that comes with this torque checker, then just pop your torque driver into the torque checker and give it a twist. If the red LED is illuminated, then there's a problem with the torque driver. And if the green one comes on, then the driver is working at the acceptable value. Just to head off any objections at the pass here, this is simply the equivalent of using a cal card to make sure that your tester is reading accurately. You may carry this out once a month to make sure that it's all working correctly. So this test with a torque checking device just makes sure that our driver is operating within the right limits. Now, this type of device is great for a check, but it won't tell you if the device is operating correctly at a range of settings. So periodically, your torque screwdriver will need taken to a specialist for calibration. Again, there's no law on how often this must be done, and it will vary depending on how regularly your device is used and the conditions that it's used in. If you use it every day and you leave your screwdriver rattling around in a toolbox in the back of the van, then it will need calibrating more often than if you do one consumer unit a year and store your torque checking device on a satin pillow. However, there are some industry norms that we can work within, and actually the manufacturer may give you some guidance on this subject as well. For instance, in the box for the Wiha iTorque, you can see that you get a factory test certificate showing that it's operating correctly at the point of manufacture, and down at the bottom of the sheet here is a space to write the date you started using the driver. This is needed because just to the left of it is some direction from Wiha stating that the tool needs to be calibrated after either 5,000 clicks or 1 year of use. And again, this value of 5,000 clicks is one that you'll find across a range of torque setting devices as a recommended value for recalibrating, and handily, the iTorque actually keeps track of your clicks for you, which is pretty awesome. If, however, you have a torque device that doesn't do that for you, and you don't obsessively count and record the clicks like a totally normal person, then you can opt to recalibrate annually instead. Again, this may sound like an additional thing to worry about, but if we liken it back to our multifunction tester, we've probably got quite used to the idea that we need to send it off for calibration once a year to make sure that it's testing accurately. So it's just the same principle for your torque screwdriver. We had a quick Google of companies that carry this out, and you're looking at about 35 quid for calibration of a torque driver with a 3-day turnaround, so it's not overly onerous. So there we go. That's how to check your torque screwdriver is operating correctly and setting screws to the right level of torque. But as always, we want to hear from you. Do you have a calibration system in place for your equipment? Do you think we'll see more and more items with requirements for accurate torque settings in the electrical industry? Whatever your thoughts and questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.